celebrate individuals who have dedicated so much of themselves to help build a more prosperous community for all of us. You know, the greatness of our nation, we just sang our song, really comes from the strength of our citizens and all of those who work so hard to become Canadians. And every now and then, it really is important to recognize the significant achievements of others. Even though I know all of you today seek no such public acclamation, but today is your day, and we want to celebrate your contributions by presenting you each with the Queen's Diamond Jubilee Medal. The Queen's Diamond Jubilee Medal is a tangible and it's a lasting way to pay tribute to Canadians whose achievements have benefited their fellow citizens, or have benefited their community, have benefited their organizations, and ultimately benefited our country. The medal itself was commissioned by our government to celebrate Her Majesty's accession to the throne 60 years ago. Think about it, 60 years, and what the Queen has seen in the past 60 years. And she really has dedicated her entire life to public service and the service of others. And through it all, has remained a positive role model for each and every one of us. And similarly, I am sure we can all draw on the inspiration of service demonstrated by your stories here today and the contributions in which we all share. So now comes the point in time where I'm going to individually say a few words, not very many, about the individuals who are receiving the medals. I'll ask you to come up as I call your name, and you'll stand here while we'll say very nice things about you, and then the mayor will present along with me the medal. So with that, first in alphabetical order, I would like to call Samantha Atum up to the front. Congratulations.
every recipient far from it, but just to emphasize, you know, the great work and relationship that you alluded to with Mary and I here in the town hall. I only want to say thank you for mentioning that. And again, I refer to these times as capturing the moment, and of course, Mary, as you know, has been on long-term leave there from the town here. And he's got not only his wife, but he's got his little granddaughter with him today. So I'm going to ask her to come up here. I'm going to ask that little great, just because I got a great granddaughter doesn't mean that everybody else. This is Mario's granddaughter.
Strives to deliver quality education, while Halton and Milton specifically Just once, maybe.
It was just once.
Just once, and he handled it well. Tiny Tots on parade, and of course, the Santa Claus parade, and a community favorite, Cruising on a Hot Summer's Night. What a classic car show that we all go to every year. So for those things, Donna, and for the things that you will continue to contribute to our community, I'm very pleased, we are very pleased to award to you on behalf of the Governor General your Queen's Diamond Jubilee Medal.
Thank you.
sitting on the words in my office, was very excited that your name came up. He said, "That's my principal." And I said, "You're no longer in high school." Diamond Jubilee. Ajit Singh School, both of which he opened. Whenever I had the opportunity to be at the Tiger Jeet Singh School, I can tell you that Rick has enormous respect. So my kids are in the school system as well, too. And I have to say that, Rick, you command attention and respect through quietness. And I've never seen that done before as a principal. And I think that's just absolutely remarkable. And more remarkable, he knows his students and their parents by name, which is a very difficult prospect when you know how large these populations are. We're very lucky to have a principal like Rick here in our community, so involved, so giving, and so caring. So, your peers in the community have nominated you, and I have the great pleasure on behalf of the Governor General, along with the Mayor, of presenting to you your Queen's Diamond Jubilee Medal.
Queen's Diamond.
piece of that small editorial there as well. I think that Mike would probably second that motion you just made. And of course, my involvement, I invested $2 back some time ago at Prosperity One. Mike is still looking after and doing a great job.
So many of your stories, and I'm so very proud to be a
recipients up here to get a group shot, because the biggest majority of mine know are certainly from your riding, and a lot of them are certainly within the town of Milton. To capture that moment is going to be very important. And again, you had mentioned, as Father Mark Curtis had mentioned about a humbling experience, and of course, as you're well aware, you almost brought me to my knees, and that's very hard to do to humble me. Back some time ago now, it was on April the 20th.
It was, it's on April
12th. It was on my birthday.
I am.
When a meeting was set up, and I had no idea why, but I soon found out later, at the superstore, and of course, it was set up 2 or 3 weeks before, and of course, I get involved in many, many things, as you had suspected. Of course, Darlene is one of my assistants. She has been for years and years. So about 2 days before this meeting at Superstore, I'm usually pretty good at doing my homework. I go to Darlene and I said, "You got any idea what this is all about?" She says, "Honestly, Mayor, I have no idea. I'm in touch with these great office. They don't know that they're going to be there." And I said, "Okay, well, I'll go and I'll find out what it's all about." So away I go, and unbeknown to me, we do a little bit of a tour of the store, and I've been in the Superstore. Go behind the scenes. That was kind of neat. I certainly enjoyed it. But anyway, come chit-chat, the idle chat. Lisa finally says to me, "You're probably wondering what you're doing here." No kidding, Lisa. Yeah. She says, "Look over there." Well, what do I see? I see Darlene, my assistant. I see my wife, some of my family, and other people that I know personally quite well. And I knew it was my birthday, and I see a cake sitting over there, and I thought, well, it's kind of my, you know, lo and behold, it was the happy birthday thing. And Lisa finally said, "Do you know what you're really here for?" And I said, "No." My birthday, she said, "No." And that's when she made the presentation to me at the preview. Literally, you could have blown me over, so I'm sure. I'm rarely ever lost for words, as you can probably tell now. But I truly was that particular day, and I really was humbled by that experience, as I suspect every one of you are here today. Now, this young lady that's just coming in here now, I recognize her as well, so I suspect there's something here.
I don't think she needs to sit down. She perhaps should come and stand with you, Mr. Mayor. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Kathleen Blank. Events run smoothly and effectively so that we may pay our respects to those who serve. So